Good morning and welcome to worship this day. Thanks for being here. I don't know if you know this or not about me or not, but I was not supposed to be here today. I was supposed to be at the Isle of Palms this weekend for the South Carolina Lutheran Men Convention, annual quarterly meeting. Of course, that got canceled. But I'm hosting it here, so you might see some men. I hear my thing ringing. You might see some men around here this afternoon that you don't recognize. Because we'll be having that meeting, I think it's probably 20 of us, but we're going to be in the assembly room, because in the fellowship hall is the blood drive. So today is the blood drive, and I want you to know that there is a critical shortage for blood, and we're just asking if you are willing to give blood, they are willing to take it, but it's from 11:30 until 4, and if you're willing and able to do that, we would really appreciate it. They changed their protocol, and we do have to wear a mask during the donation process, but that's the least we can do, right? Yeah, that's the least we can do. I also want to let you know that Cindy Thurman is in the hospital. She went through the ED a couple of times this week, and then they admitted her. So she is at Baptist. And again, with COVID protocol, the only way, only one person can visit, right, Dennis? One person can visit each day. So if somebody goes in for 5 minutes, nobody else can go for the rest of the day. So it's kind of one of those crazy rules, but we have to follow those rules. So Dennis, Denise, I'm sure they would take your calls and keep you updated, which that's what they've been doing for me, because, like I said, we can't get into the hospital. But on a good thing that happens at the hospitals, babies are born, and you should have gotten that email this week that Watson Murdoch Martin was born, and they are all home. Which reminds me, if you did not get the email, send a note to me, PastorGina@wearemountherman.com, and we'll add you to that list so that you will know all the e-news that we send out. We don't send out something every week, so if you see something, it's probably pretty pertinent, and you should probably look at it. Second thing I want to remind you is that September 25th is the chicken stew. And they will be selling tickets this day. Since it's raining, they will be in the breezeway. It's $7 a plate or $9 a quart. Always a chance to educate. Why are they selling tickets in the breezeway and not the doorway? Any ideas? You remember when Jesus went into the temple? And they were selling things, and he turned over the tables. Well, that's part of it. We don't want Jesus to come in here and turn over tables. But the second thing is, Jesus appears to get very angry because they are actually selling things that they need to bring into the sanctuary for a sacrifice. They're selling things like birds and animals for those sacrifices. And it appears the reason Jesus gets so upset is they were selling them from a profit. They were, in other words, as a hurricane comes towards New York, they were doing something we call price gouging. Well, if we're selling chicken stew tickets, we're doing it not just as a something to give away, but rather we're hoping to make a little bit of a profit, which we reduce the debt around here. So, therefore, we don't sell anything between the back doors of the church and the sanctuary. So it's always going to be off stream. So that's why it's on the breezeway. So that's my long explanation of why we won't be selling tickets, etc., as you walk into the door. I think that that's all the announcements. Ruthie, do you have anything? We're finished with the liturgy. We're all good on that. I think that's all we have. So let us prepare our hearts for worship.
Thank you.
you stand and face the baptismal font? Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the God of manna, the God of miracles, and the God of mercy. Amen. And now I invite you to turn and face the doors of the sanctuary where we come in as broken children and we ask for God's forgiveness. Drawn to Christ and seeking God's abundance, let us confess our sin. God, our provider, help us. It is hard to believe there is enough to share. We question your ways when they differ from the ways of the world in which we live. We turn to our own understanding rather than trusting in you. We take offense at your teachings and your ways. Turn us again to you. Where else can we turn? Share with us the words of eternal life and feed us for life in the world. Amen. Beloved people of God, in Jesus, the manna from heaven, we are fed and we are nourished. By Jesus, the worker of miracles, there is always more than enough. Through Jesus, the bread of life, we are shown God's mercy. We are forgiven and loved into abundant life. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Thank you.
pray together. Holy God, your word feeds your people with life that is eternal. Direct our choices and preserve us in your truth, that renouncing what is false and evil, we may live in you. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. You may be seated for the readings.
A reading from Joshua. Then Joshua gathered all the tribes of Israel to Shechem and summoned the elders, the heads, the judges, and the officers of Israel, and they presented themselves before God. And Joshua said to all the people, "Now therefore revere the Lord and serve him in sincerity and in faithfulness. Put away the gods that your ancestors served beyond the river and in Egypt, and serve the Lord. Now, if you are unwilling to serve the Lord, choose this day whom you will serve, whether the gods your ancestors served in the region beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you are living. But as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord." Then the people answered, "Far be it from us that we should forsake the Lord to serve other gods. For it is the Lord our God who brought us and our ancestors up from the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery, and who did those great signs in our sight. He protected us along all the way that we went, and among all the peoples through whom we passed. And the Lord drove out before us all the peoples, the Amorites who lived in the land. Therefore, we also will serve the Lord, for he is our God." Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God. We will read Psalm 34 responsively. The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and God's ears are open to their cry. The face of the Lord is against those who do evil, to erase the remembrance of them from the earth. The righteous cry, and the Lord hears them and delivers them from all their troubles. The Lord is near to the brokenhearted and saves those whose spirits are crushed. Many are the troubles of the righteous, but the Lord delivers them from every one. God will keep safe all their bones. Not one of them shall be broken. Evil will bring death to the wicked, and those who hate the righteous will be punished. O Lord, you redeem the life of your servants, and those who put their trust in you will not be punished. A reading from Ephesians. Be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his power. Put on the whole armor of God, so that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For our struggle is not against enemies of blood and flesh, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers of this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, so that you may be able to withstand on that evil day, and having done everything, to stand firm. Stand, therefore, and fasten the belt of truth around your waist, and put on the breastplate of righteousness. As shoes for your feet, put on whatever will make you ready to proclaim the gospel of peace. With all of these, take the shield of faith, with which you will be able to quench all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Pray in the Spirit at all times in every prayer and supplication. To that end, keep alert and always persevere in supplication for all the saints. Pray also for me, so that when I speak, a message may be given to me to make known with boldness the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare it boldly as I must speak. Word of God, word of life, thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel according to St. John, the 6th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said, "Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me, I live because of the Father. So whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which your ancestors ate and they died, but the one who eats this bread will live forever." Note this verse. He said these things while he was teaching in the synagogue at Capernaum. Then John says, "When many of the disciples heard it, they said, 'This teaching is difficult. Who can accept it?' But Jesus, being aware that the disciples were complaining about it, said to them, 'Does this offend you? Then what if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life. The flesh is useless. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life.' Hear this. But among you there are some who do not believe. For Jesus knew from the first who were the ones that did not believe and who was the one who would betray him. And Jesus said, 'For this reason I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted by the Father.'" Again, hear this. Because of this, many of his disciples turned back and no longer went with Jesus. So Jesus asked the 12, "Do you also wish to go away?" But Simon Peter answered him, "Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and know that you are the Holy One of God." And Jesus answered them, "Did I not choose you, the 12? Yet one of you is the devil." He was speaking of Judas, the son of Simon Iscariot, for he, the one of the 12, was going to betray Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated. Students, I have a chore for you. The rest of you older students, too. Will you take off your shoe? Will you take off your shoe and hold it up? Yeah, you got your shoes off? Yeah, good. Did you hear in that reading that Mr. Wynn wrote about us having our shoes on to go proclaim the gospel? Let me see your shoes again. What do they look like? Yep, some of them are high-heeled. Some of them are flat. Yes, some of them are flat. Some of them are closed. Some of them you can see whether or not you need a pedicure. Right? All kinds of shoes. But we wear, you know, these kind of shoes back here. Yeah, they all have on shoes. How many times do you leave home, students, without wearing shoes? Sometimes? Spencer, certainly you don't put on your flip-flops to go jump in the pool, do you? No, you don't do that. Sometimes we put on our shoes and because we are to go and to talk and we are to talk about Jesus and we are to be his hands and his feet. So whatever your shoes look like, may your shoes be molded to your feet so that you can go talk about Jesus to your friends. All right, you can put your shoes back on if you want to. You don't have to. It's holy ground in here. Let us pray. Gracious God, we thank you for shoes that protect our feet, but also shoes that encourage us and allows us to go places that otherwise we couldn't walk, like hot sand and big rocks. So God, we thank you for giving us the things that we need to go proclaim and to teach your word. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, parents, I have a question for you. Kids, too. Did you ever watch the dating game? Did you ever watch the dating game? For those of you who have no idea what the dating game is, it was a show before The Bachelor and The Bachelorette. You got that one? It's a lot like that. But you see, in the dating game, it was like this. There was only three people and not 27. And they were behind this curtain. And the one person who was going to choose their date was out front. And they asked questions, right? They asked questions about these three people so that they could decide which one of those behind the curtain was going to get to go on a date. So they went through this series of asking questions so that this person could choose one that would go on a date. And then after they went on a date, they came back, and quite often things went okay, sometimes good, sometimes bad. But rarely did it come back and say, one saying, well, I thought it went really good, and the other say, I thought it went bad. Usually they agreed that the date was either really bad or it was really good. They were total strangers that were going out together. And we might think that that's a little strange, but I want to ask you a question. They were looking for a relationship. So I'm going to ask you this question. How many of you have a spouse? Raise your hand. A spouse, family members, co-workers, the lady at the front desk, someone who sits near you in church. Like, we all have somebody near us, right, that we want to be in relationship with. Do you always agree with them? Do spouses always agree? Dion, don't you answer. Do spouses always agree? No. No, we don't always agree. Sometimes we disagree. But I often say this, that you find more out about a person when they disagree and they don't get their way than when you do agree. Because when you're two peas in a pod, you hardly ever disagree. But we want to be in that relationship, and we want to be surrounded by people who love us and support us and push us forward and sometimes make us change shoes. You know, sometimes take off the flip-flops and get on like some tennis shoes so that you can go walk or whatever it is. Those relationships cause us to change, don't they? Regardless of whatever they are, they cause us to change because we want these relationships. So this last couple of weeks, we've been studying John. John 1:1 starts like this. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was with God. Sounds a lot like Genesis. Tie back. You might not have known that, but if I say to you, what is John 3:16? Tell me what it is. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was with God. Does that sound like a relationship? Yeah. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever should die for us, we will have eternal life. Does that sound like a relationship? Yeah. Fast forward three more chapters in John 6:6. You know, our 6:35 says, whoever comes to me and believes in me will never be hungry and never be thirsty. Does that sound like relationship? Yeah. So we're at the end of John 6. My granddaddy used to say, the rubber hits the road. Did you hear today that Jesus is saying, I want you to be in a relationship with me? And the disciples said to them, oh, that's a little bit tough there. That's kind of hard questions that you're making me do. And John's listening in, and John, as he recalls, he says that some of them started complaining. The establishment of the first church. They started complaining among themselves because they didn't want to have to do what Jesus was asking them to do. And then Jesus reminds them, You have been in the presence of the Son of God. You have seen us feed 5,000 people with leftovers. You have seen people being healed in His name. You are seeing all of these things along the way. And I want you to be in a deeper relationship with me. So now that you've seen and experienced all of these things, it's now time to like take our relationship to a new level. It's kind of like, if we're not going to get married, I'm going to find another boyfriend. You know, people do that, right? It's time for us to take this relationship to another level. And we know in our own situations where sometimes the person's not ready for that big C word, commitment, and they decide not to. But in some cases, it kind of prompts them to be in a deeper relationship. So Jesus is asking us today, as He asked the disciples then, to be in a deeper relationship with Him. He longs for that deep, deep relationship where we take off our shoes and we get up close personal and we share things with others and we proclaim who Jesus is. He's asking us that. And sometimes it is too hard. And sometimes we would rather not. But Jesus is telling us today that either you do or you don't. And then Jesus reminds His disciples. So He's talking to them. And did you hear He called His inner group? We know He called them disciples and apostles. And He's already starting to recruit and He has more disciples because He said some of them haven't totally bought in, and they decided to go on their way. But as He talks to these 12, He also says, you know, I chose you. I chose you to be in this relationship, and one of you, it ain't gonna work out. Even the one that Jesus has chosen in this dating game knows it's not going to work out. Judas has chosen not to be in a relationship with Jesus. If you remember in John's gospel, I think it's about the 13th chapter where they talk, where Judas is about, Jesus has given them the Lord's Supper, and then it's nighttime and Judas leaves. He walked out on the relationship. Judas walked out. And John says it best, and it was dark. It was night, whatever that word is. He walked out. Jesus does not want us to walk out, but rather He wants us to come closer to the light so that all is illuminated and everything that He has given us gets to be bigger and brighter. Michelle and I were talking this morning. I kept looking around. Jeff, don't take this personally. But I kept looking around thinking there must be some lights out because it feels kind of dark in here today. And she reminded me that the light outside was not quite as bright today. It was raining when y'all walked in, right? But Jesus wants us to be in the light. He wants us to be bright. And He wants everything about us to be shining so that He can choose what we are to do. Thanks be to God that life is not a dating game. It's not about one choosing one of us, but it is about Him choosing all of us, about all of us being part of the one. Not Him choosing one, but Him choosing all of humanity. And because we're not puppets on a string, we get to choose. My prayer is that we all choose to be in this relationship with God. That we choose to walk in deeper boots. That we choose to get knee deep in following Christ in a new and a different and a more meaningful and a more special way this day. So, get your shoes on so that we can go proclaim God's love and grace and mercy in this world. Amen. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith with the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Made children and heirs of God's promise, we pray for the church, the world, and all in need. Merciful God, let us be your servant to follow what Jesus taught us to be peacemakers among people and nations, and bless us through the fruits of peace and love on earth. Plant in our hearts the seeds of shalom, and grow them with your holy water, so that we are prepared to be your instrument and bloom flowers of your peace. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Gracious God, we give you thanks for this day. We thank you for inviting us to be in relationship with you. We thank you for encouraging us and forgiving us even when we complain. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
And gracious God, we ask for your healing hand this day. We ask that you continue to comfort Angie. We ask that you send your healing spirit to care for those who we know in this congregation. We especially pray this day for Cindy. We pray for Linda Waters Hamilton, Joe Leach, Jimmy Maddox, Jerry Price, Earl Cease, and Jane Sexton. And God, we also pray for those who are in their homes or in different facilities. We pray this day for Patricia Backman, Alberta Berry, Hazel Bacchus, Lyle Bacchus, Nell Buff, Janar Kaiser, Reverend Everett Price, June Roof, Tom Roof, and Lena Wessinger. And God, we give you glory this day for a healthy baby. We give you thanks for Watson Murdoch Martin. And we give thanks for Mom and Dad and Sophie. We give you thanks for sending us a new angel this day. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And God, we have more names to bring to you this day. May you hear those names that we say out loud, and may you hear those names that we tuck away and hold silent in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And God, we pray also this day for the American Red Cross. May you bring people this day to donate blood. We also pray this day for the South Carolina Lutheran Men and Mission. May you send your spirit to guide them. And we also pray this day, God, for those who are suffering from dementia. And we ask that you continue to bless the ministry that we will host next week. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God, we thank you for loving us, for caring for us, and for being always being there, inviting us to be in relationship. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And God, whatever else is that you know we need this day, may you receive these prayers, O God, and those in our hearts known and unknown to you, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. And at this time, we all give our offerings back to God. So if you're online and you would like to donate online, you're welcome to do that. You may also send a check to the church. But however it is that we give back to God, it's part of our worship this day. Amen.
You sing to me rivers I bring.
And we pray together. Jesus, bread of life, you have set this table with your very self and called us to the feast of plenty. Gather what has been sown among us and strengthen us in this meal. Make us to be what we receive here, your body for the life of the world. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right. It's our duty and it's our joy that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. So it was in the night that Jesus wanted a relationship with the disciples, and he took bread and he gave thanks and he broke it. And he gave it to his disciples saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And at that same table, he took a cup and he gave thanks and he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering his love for us on the way at this table and to the end, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen, and Christ will come again. We pray for the gift of your Spirit in this gathering, within this meal, among your people, and throughout the world. Blessing, praise, and thanks to you, Holy God, through Jesus, by your Spirit, in your world without end. Amen. And Lord, keep us in a relationship with you and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. There is more than enough, so come and be fed at this table.
Let your love come home.
Please stand. And now may the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen. Amen.
We pray together. Living God, as the disciples ate and drank with their risen Lord, we have been nourished with the very presence of Christ. Through this meal, may we be strengthened to keep your word and to proclaim the power of your love in Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. And now receive this blessing. The blessing of God, who provides for us, feeds us, and journeys with us, may he be upon you now and forever. Amen. We follow the light of Christ into the world because we are God's people on a mission. We have gathered, we have been fed, and now we go out to make a difference in the world. Amen.
Amen.